No, I'm just thinking, you know, Renaissance, you know, civilization, especially since, you know, there's a, what looks to be a, well, you guys have really
fucking
around bitter.
It's the only thing that got him killed.
No, mortally wounded and neutered.
And then first killed.
Proceed with what you were saying, because Roger interrupted poorly.
So, I'm gonna, if they don't try to stop me, I'm gonna hurriedly pack up my gear, tip my hat to them both, and, well, ask them what direction City Hall is in, I suppose.
They point behind you, and as you look, you see a giant building.
Ah, yes. Thank you, gentlemen. Gonna tip my hat again. Won't be a moment, and I'm gonna make a beeline for City Hall.
Alright.
As if out of a cartoon.
Let's see, Flambart's gonna just be a stick in the mud.
What do you expect?
Valerie's gonna probably spend the rest of her money, gain that last cure spell, and then your flute, your perform was a 15. That is a, hang on, give me 1 second on that. I think that's a D10 of silver. But, Roger, Leon, as you are just hanging out, you, the merfolk's gonna kind of walk up to you and say, do you have time for a walk?
She's obviously nobility, right?
She, from the way she dresses, you can kind of hint that.
I'll stand up, kind of tuck the gun on my back, still within arm's reach so I can easily get if I needed to, and say, of course.
Alright, and then she's going to kind of head out. She kind of moves rather slow on land, as you can tell.
She doesn't have a strong fin.
No.
See, I know a thing or two about merfolk.
She doesn't move too fast, but you know that she can. She walks at a what would be like a mild pace for you. But yeah. So we'll get back to you. You're gonna walk around the city for a bit. Let's get back to Belford. Belford, as you enter the city hall, you notice that there's a rather large line, like a queue for the, for people at the desk.
How long? Like, almost to the door?
Yes, like, literally, you open the door and you see the line in front of you.
Well, I suppose I'm going to take my place in line.
If only.
All right, let's see how. Let's see how many hours it takes for you to actually get to the end. Awesome! It only took you 3 hours to get to get there, and while those 3 hours are happening, and Valerie is doing her little flute song and dance, and I'm assuming Kato's kind of being meditative, monkey, mysterious.
Congratulations, you figured out how monks are played in spare time.
I assume he'd walk around and try to see the sights.
It's a monk.
Yes, but not all monks are, you know, quiet.
He's taken two vows. I'm pretty sure he doesn't plan on doing anything.
Well, especially vow of silence, vow of truth.
Yeah.
Well, did he take the vow of celibacy?
How would he? I'm not even gonna start making jokes about that.
That is actually a feat in the book.
Wilder's the way.
That is a feat in the book. It gives you a +2 to a stat of your choice. So, you know.
I didn't say I allowed those. I allowed certain things.
Put pressure on him.
Put pressure on me, and I will throw an ogre at you.
And I'll shoot it, then run away and reload in the set while I'm running. He won't catch me.
So, Leon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's gonna... The motherfuckers, after a while, she's gonna basically buy a few different things. Mostly scrolls and ink. And then she's going to say out of nowhere, "So I heard that you met someone dressed in, some leather armor and wielding exotic blades yesterday."
I heard something about that, but I was focused on my rifle. Why?
Just curious if you actually saw him.
Myself, no. I did not. Like I said, I was focused on the rifle.
She's gonna sigh and say, "Well, that was a pointless excursion. I need to go find the other one." And then she's gonna say, "Well, if you ever see him again, don't get in his way. It's rather best you also don't mention him, about him."
You know, just kind of shrugs, like, you know, whatever.
Good to... And then after a while, she's going to say, "You're not much for words, are you?"
Not a lot of need for them.
You're rather by the rules soldier, aren't you?
I've been part of the military for as long as I can remember, yeah.
They don't mind me asking, why did you join this caravan?
The army figured it'd be a good idea to make sure that some of our nobles made it back. Obviously indicating towards... what's her face? I have it here somewhere. Val's mistress, yes.
You don't see her.
Lady Jethal. No, but no, that's obviously what I'm talking about, is what I'm getting at. Not in like indicating his thing, pointing towards, but like indicating with voice. Pointing a meaning towards.
Okay, indicating, but she's just going to kind of chuckle. Right. She's just going to kind of chuckle, then she's going to say, "Well, considering that you got a recommendation from a legendary hero, especially Varyl the Phoenix, I assume that you would have another intention. Because I'm sure someone that, like you, with knowing the right people, could get any position that they wanted."
Yeah, just do what I'm told. I don't really care.
Really? So if they told you to jump off a bridge, would you do it?
There are obviously certain restrictions based upon the oaths I've taken to the military, but within reason, I should say then. If you would like me to be more specific about it.
Hmm. You know what? Might as well. We're going to have been walking for quite some time. And you're the only other person I can really talk to around here outside of, well, my servant. Do you need time on that one?
Wait, what? I'm sorry, I'm only half listening, because it didn't seem like it was something that was actually angled towards me at the time. What did she say?
She said she'd be interested in hearing your, What things you would not be against. By the way, I feel like we're missing someone.
It's because according to that, we are.
According to dropped.
Yeah, he's not showing.
Nick's back. It's the other one that dropped that isn't showing
yet. Yeah,
it's
Nate. I'm throwing him another call. Because... goddamn crickets.
Somebody's... Nick is in 20. I'm in 20.
Yeah, it doesn't show you're in
Jeff
20.
Is
I'm
in
here.
20. Somebody's not in 20.
Yeah, Nate isn't.
It's like he just left.
Mm.
Probably because so
no,
far...
Did he say something about having to leave?
No, I didn't think he said anything about having to leave.
I don't recall it.
I didn't see anything in chat anywhere.
He's still in the game. So anyway, hell, I don't know. I didn't think about that. Just the basic.
I can give you a minute.
It's kind of the more basic kind of ideals of, you know, I'm not gonna kill self, I'm not gonna injure self, not, you know,
right.
Standard things that people wouldn't do if told to, like say a servant.
Right.
That's kind of what I he sees himself as a dog in the military. Yes, you know exactly where I stole that phrase. Don't even.
Yep.
Yeah.
I think we all know where that phrase came from. Yeah. Where it got popularized, I should say.
Are you wearing that uniform?
No, I'm wearing a military uniform, but it's not that one.
Damn.
But anyways,
The crickets are quite accurate for this situation.
Yes, I don't know. I think that's out of. I think I ran out of questions. I was writing these up during combat.
Well, let's see. Valerie's playing a flute. Just
and
busking right now.
You're actually.
Street performer trying to get money.
I'm right, in a queue.
Yep. And Kato kind of left.
Like I said, I think we kind of know.
Kato's meditating.
Yes, we know.
Either way, he's out of the call. So, and I was trying to develop character here. God damn it!
You're gonna have to try harder with mine, and you know why.
Yeah, that's.
You know why? Don't even. You're using the wrong person to try it.
I know, but I'm trying to pry at your character because your character is.
I know, but you're using the wrong character to do so.
Yes, I know. But the character that would develop it more is kind of MIA. Anyways,
not
let's get
that
back
one.
To...
There is one within the caravan who would be better suited.
I'm trying to think who.
Wow. We went over mentioned her like 5 minutes ago. God, you're sure. Dense. Lady Jethal. Lady Jethal, you moron.
Oh. Lady Jethal. Wait.
Noble and the Imperium.
Oh, right.
Derp.
So noble from the waters of Illinari is not going to help you.
No, probably not.
Wrong noble.
But yeah, but that noble lady is so self-centered that it's not even funny. Makes Victor look like fucking anyone that gives their money away to charity. Anyways.
That noble lady's going to die if I have anything to say about it.
So,
you're likely to end up with a rifle
so,
in the face
what's
when you do
doctor,
that.
You get to the end of the line, and the lady says, "How? Hi, how can I help you?" English is hard today.
Yes, I'm Dr. Belford. I'd like a trade permit, please.
Okay, she's going to take out some paperwork, and then she's going to ask, "How long are you going to stay here?" I'm assuming for the end of the fair.
How long did it say in the letter that we had?
You didn't get a letter yet.
Oh.
Say a few days.
I've genuinely forgotten how long he said we'd be in town for.
He didn't give an exact number.
Say a few days.
We'll say a few days.
Always
just
say
a few days.
If you never know, the answer is always a few days.
Alright, she's gonna start writing some things down, and then she's gonna hand you some paperwork, and then she's gonna say. And then she is... Actually, no, she's not going to hand you paperwork. She's going to say, well, I need a deposit of 2 gold, please.
Shit.
You don't have 2 gold, do you?
I used my gold to make the potion.
Oh my god! You are so broke! Am I the only one in this party that actually has money?
You had a certain start that we didn't have, to be fair.
Yeah, but that money wasn't helped with it.
Mm.
That's money from being level 3 that I have left over. I didn't that wasn't added into a general pool.
Just you didn't have to buy as much as the rest of us.
I have a question
money
for you.
On my
I have an answer.
Were I to go and get money, how long would it take me to get back to this point?
That depends. How are you going to get the money?
I'm going to sell one of my potions in a store. In a shop.
Alright, considering that it's still pre-noon. Actually, no, it's actually afternoon at this point. See, it's afternoon. We could say it would take you... Are you going to ask for directions for the closest store?
Yes.
Who are you gonna ask?
I'm just gonna ask the clerk.
She's gonna look mildly annoyed, and then she's just gonna say, next, forcing you out of the line.
I'm gonna walk out, dejected, and I'm gonna look for the nearest store.
The nearest store is a general store.
You're getting so screwed, I love it.
I'm gonna walk in. I'm gonna shuffle over to the counter.
The general store clerk is gonna kind of look at you and say, "Hey, how can I help you?"
I've been better. I don't suppose I could interest you in a potion of enlarge person.
I have no use for that around here.
Potion of cure light wounds.
We can start talking business from there. How much are you selling it for?
Just a second, I need to pull it up here.
A price check.
Actually, I do have a praise.
It's market value for whatchamacallit. A cure light potion of cure light wounds is 50 GP.
I'm going to sell it for 40 GP then. I'd like to sell this to you. How does 40 sound?
That's quite a bit much. Don't you think you can cut it down to maybe 30?
What's maybe split the difference of 35?
Diplomacy.
Oh, this is gonna be just fantastic.
I'm actually enjoying this.
Oh no, I actually have a bonus to diplomacy. Okay.
Oh. Let's see it.
One. I was so close.
Bit low on cash, as you can see right now. I've been spending all my money to set up a little kiosk at the fair tomorrow. So I don't have exactly 40 GP lying around, but I can definitely take it for 30. That's my final offer.
All right. And I'm gonna start muttering under my breath. It'll be worth it. It'll be worth it. It'll be worth it.
He'll take the take out a pouch and put some gold coins in it and kind of give it to you. And then takes the potion. And he's gonna say, "Have a nice day."
I'm gonna tip my hat and sprint back to City Hall.
This is you are a cartoon character at this point.
Pretty much.
I hope you realize this.
I was not expecting this.
You're like running back and forth as quick as you can. You are freaking here for a second, tip pat, pew, cloud and everything behind you.
When you get back to City Hall,
I'm doing the anime sprint with my arms raised up. Toast in my mouth.
Alright, so you basically get back to City Hall and you see that the lines have gotten rather longer, as in they're outside the door now.
Worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it.
And it'll take you another 6 hours to get to the table. Well, to the, little thing.
Oh, I've been hitting my nose so hard it's actually bleeding now. I guess I should be expecting this. The hubris.
I'm just gonna continue muttering under my breath the whole way. It'll be worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it, it'll be worth it.
Alright, give me a second. So Leon, if you can answer that question.
Yeah, I know.
Why is it saying I'm the only other person in Roll20 right now?
You know what's interesting? Because it says that I have both our DM, you, and myself showing up, but I'll reload.
I don't see you anywhere. I'm going to refresh.
I'm refreshing.
I did that
as
earlier,
well.
And I'm still only getting Dr. Jeff.
Something's going on.
I'm in Roll20 according to mine, so I don't know. Mm.
Alright.
Yeah, it's new.
So, Roger.
Mm.
So, after a while, as the two of you are heading back to the caravan, she's then going to say, Surely a commissioned officer like yourself must have a lady waiting back home for you, especially in the Imperium.
Indeed, I do.
And who would that be?
I'd prefer to keep her name out of this. She has no involvement in any of this. No need to drag her into anything.
Well, I'm just simply curious.
It's not a name you would recognize.
Try me. She looks kind of insulted as you say that.
So I'm going to make up a name on the fly then, because I'm not giving you that satisfaction that easy. Plus, besides, he's trying to keep his true purpose on the down low, so... Shrink
yes.
It. Would it be her name?
Can you repeat that and hear it?
Shrinka. Oh, I will type it out for you as well. Because in case it ever
Ellen
comes up again. Because I actually know this off the top of my head.
She's going to kind of ponder for a bit. Sounds like it comes from the lands of Travask.
I've never asked where she came from. Not that it matters too much.
She's going to kind of look at you suspiciously. And then be rather quiet for this. And then you guys are going to get to the caravan, and then she's going to say, well, thanks for the chat. It was rather interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Just keep what I told you about earlier, rather on the down low.
I hadn't planned on mentioning it anyway.
Thank you. And then she's going to kind of head off. Alright, so I guess the rest of the day you guys are going to do your thing. God damn it, Jeff. Alright, so tell Jeff I'm going to be right back real quick. I need to start my laundry so I can get ready for work tomorrow. So, well, Jeff's BRBing, because I need to roleplay the whole him getting the permit again. So I'll be right back.
Oh, this is going to go well. It went so great the first time.
One word for it.
It went so great the first time.
Yeah, there's a couple ways this might go. I don't think well is one of them.
Nor do I. Oh, good. He's back. Unfortunately, unfortunately, our DM is no longer here.
Lovely.
So you're going to
just
have
to get
to...
a drink and laundry.
Yeah, and then do laundry. You're going to have to redo your role playing with the clerk. This is going to go so well.
Yay.
I love it.
I know exactly what I'm going to start off with.
Oh man, this is going to work out so poorly for you. You know that, right?
I know.
You are one uncharismatic fuck. Am I any more charismatic now that I say that? No, probably not. Do I have any? No, I don't even have a bonus to diplomacy.
I have a plus one.
You can tell in the gruff way I hold myself that I'm not a one that's good with dealing with people. Though looks, I'm not half bad, since, you know, multiple factors. Something I've always had an ire with is that everybody always assumes charisma is only about physical appearance when it has to do with, you know, the way you present yourself, the way you talk, the way you're confident in yourself, the way you look. You know, it's a combination of a bunch of different things. So you can say that even with a lower charisma, you just suck at dealing with people, but you look pretty good. You know? Kind of evens out to be average.
I am slightly better than average at talking to people.
I suck at talking with people, but I'm not the ugliest person you've ever seen. I'm also not... I'm above average in that aspect, since I suck ass at talking. It's the way I rationalize
it. I'm back.
How's
it going?
We were discussing how everybody assumes charisma automatically means how good you look.
Nah. It's a factor, though.
See? I told you. I suck at dealing with people, so I look better. That... I have a negative in that column, so I have to get a positive in the other to balance out.
Alright, so Belford, after spending your entire day trying to get the money and waiting in line for the permit, the lady is going to look at you again. She's going to kind of look sad. Looks like she's been working.
I swear kind of... I have the money this time.
No, she just looks exhausted. This is a different woman this time.
Okay.
She's going to sigh and say, let me guess, permit next 5 days for the fair...
Yes.
She's just gonna kind of just motion for the money.
How much?
2 golds.
Lovely. I'm gonna pull out 2 gold.
Because you have it this time.
Send it out of your hands. She's gonna show you the paperwork, and then she's just gonna hand you an ink pen, and then just say, "Just sign the bottom. We can get this done."
I'm gonna dash off real quick. Dr. Ephraim Belford.
She's going to take back the contract. You're going to hear a nice loud slam. And then you're going to see a seal on it. And then she's going to say, have fun with the fair.
I'm going to tip my hat. And I'm actually going to smile for the first time since the guard showed up. It's been one long day.
It's been a shitty day for you.
Yes. Yes, it has. Oh, my.
Mr. Cartoon Character.
Cloud of dust and wheel of feet.
Not Zoidberging?
Big anime sweat drop.
But anyways,
I like that, actually. That's a better god for me. I was looking for gods, okay? Shut up.
No one's judging here. Atheist.
Click it.
The irony is, I'm going with a freaking dwarven god. I blame the military. The domain still would fit him anyway.
Anyway, so... You all get back from your very long days. Everyone seems... Well, do you guys go back to the caravan, or do you guys find an inn? Let's get to that better question.
Caravan. Well, regardless, after this very long day, I'm going to pull out my bottle of brandy.
You're just now taking a swig?
And then get arrested.
I haven't had time before.
Bullshit, you've been waiting in line!
The whole time going, it'll be worth it.
Seriously, we could replace him with a cartoon character and nobody notice a difference.
Oh my god, I'm in tears. Oh fuck. I love you guys.
Go back to the caravan for me.
Good, though. Never kill us.
Yeah. We'll see what happens. You guys haven't even gotten to the first really fun part yet.
Okay, let me rephrase that. Don't kill me.
No plans for killing any of you right now.
You can't afford
to kill me. You all are
such
interesting characters. And not only that, I've given you guys windows to interact with one another, and you guys are silent as the grave.
Hey, it fits my character.
Silent as Nate.
It fits my character, at least. Let's be fair here.
I tried, but
exactly.
Other things happened.
My character advanced.
God damn it, Stephen.
This is what happens when you get a slave and a freaking military man. We don't do shit to interact with people.
A slave, a military man, and a monk who has taken an oath of silence.
Yes, this is what
I am the only halfway personable person in the party.
With a plus one to diplomacy.
And the only other charismatic person in the frickin' party is the frickin' sixth person who was supposed to join us.
Yeah,
Brett.
No, Steven.
Who?
Steven.
He's our sixth member.
Yes, that was a drunken and exhausted decision.
It'll work well.
Somebody's supposed to be here.
Well, one person didn't realize that this was a Saturday group, and we're going to have to talk about that for the long run.
Yeah, I think he's gone.
And then we have Nate, who disappeared off the face of the planet as I was trying to develop everyone's character.
Yeah, I don't know what's up with that.
I'm developing my character like he
This
would.
Is what my entire plan was for the first session, was to develop all of your characters, which I feel like I've kind of done a half-shitty job with.
It's not your fault, though, so don't feel bad about it.
Well, one of them is a monk who's just gone, and two of them are already developed and just have silent personalities and less directly interacted with.
By the way, I just got a text. I'm not going to back because I'm pretty sure Steven would punch me in the nuts when he sees me again.
Probably. Read it.
I've already read it, but
no, to us.
Basically, oh. Anyway, so basically, Steven's no longer tipsy, so he's going to be hitting on soon.
Oh, awesome. He had to sober up before coming home. Okay.
Yeah, because let's not have a drunk, charismatic drow in the party. Which reminds me, Valerie's.
That would be awesome.
That would have been the best.
That's how this drow was created.
Yeah, exactly. That would have been the best.
That would have been so damn fantastic.
He'd at least have character and personality and be talking with people.
4 o'clock was when this. It was Friday morning. Friday morning.
Was it Friday?
At around four o'clock is when this character was actually designed and approved.
Okay. Let's make a point of this though. He would actually be interacting with people though.
Yes, which is what I'm gonna have happen.
Well.
Drunkenly, but he still would have.
I've tried interacting with two people.
I think he took Elvin and an Undercommon, right?
Yep. So the only one, literally, the only one he can speak to... Well, no, you've got Elvin.
I know Elvin. Second Lieutenant Leon Flambard knows Elvin. For good reason.
For reasons that he's not going to say, but I know about!
For reasons that if you utilize the right resources, I will talk about. But you're failing!
Well, I'm trying to poke at him.
Well, poke at me better!
Noble.
I told you how to do it, and you're failing.
Well, I'm not going to have Lady Jethal talk to you, because A, she's more of an egotist than frickin' Victor.
Oh, okay. Sweet.
That's so somehow hard to believe.
Killer?
Yes.
But she's a rapist.
She's not a rapist.
What?
In Valerie's mind, she's a rapist.
But not in the general public's mind. You are her property. She does what she wants with you.
Yeah, you're contractually her property. Ah.
She was tricked into it.
You are still her property.
She was a small town girl.
You are still your
she is a lonely world.
She took the midnight train going anywhere.
I'm not saying is it evil from a society's point of view. I'm saying from moral obligation, well, you know, with the gods of the universe, is it evil? She's simply protecting herself. I.e. alignment step. Would it be shifted? To kill her.
Does it really matter?
Outright, out of nowhere? Yes.
It's not out of nowhere. I've told you from the very beginning that's what's on her mind. It's even in her backstory.
Yes, which, are you chaotic neutral?
I mean, it's subtly in her backstory, yes.
Then you're not going to change an alignment.
Yes!
Oh, God.
However!
I just have to not get caught.
Good luck with that.
Yeah. We're in a caravan going into a tomb that's no one has ever come out of alive.
You're a barbarian. No barbarian is quiet.
Slave barbarian is, because gets beat if
I
not.
I want to go ahead and let you know, I have a 4 rogue, 1 barbarian, who's very quiet, with a +15 stealth. technically a barbarian. It's got a barbarian level.
Yes, let's look into that. Crazy
but it's no crod.
No.
I basically my character is going to be crod because she's a level 4 slayer, one barbarian.
You no see crod.
Next level, she's taking intimidating powers.
Oh Jesus Christ! Okay. Back on the story of the game.
Yes, because that totally. Fuck you guys.
Well, I'm gonna go back to the caravan because got this money.
You see Garouk and a couple of the caravan guards kind of just lounging about playing cards. Garouk in particular kind of just has his double-barreled pistol on the table. The rest of the guards kind of look intimidated by it.
Never win against a Wookiee? Is that what's going on there?
And I'm going to play with the idea of trying to sell potions to people in the caravan.
I assume Valerie will make it back to the caravan at some point.
Yep, yeah, Valerie, you're actually going to make it there first. So basically that scene's first upon you.
Yes, she'll just,
Assuming your mistress is letting you leave her. And she isn't staying with the caravan, which I don't think she would. Doesn't seem like she would.
Yeah, look, taking a quick glance around, you don't see her lying around anywhere. Well, sitting around, I should say.
That means I'm free, she hasn't called for me yet. Probably, I don't know.
I'm actually going to double check how those items work while you're just lounging around.
Oh, he's got one of those. She knows where you are.
Oh, I know that.
It's pretty bad that I've... In 4 games, I've figured out enough of stuff like that I can tell you what item it is immediately. I haven't even looked to see if he has it on his character sheet. Probably. Maybe.
Nope. It's a...
It's a wondrous item, but... It's still, like... It's,
what I've got is slightly modified from the actual item. But,
it's the neck guard.
The probably. Actual item that I'm using a modification of is the Jailer's
Ring Slave, ring. Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've actually had a bunch of those, and the actual key, the ring that allows me to see where they are, and that character ended up disappearing the next session because DM was a jackass. That was a fun session. Not. Anyway, story, if we can force it out of you.
Yes, because you guys keep on derailing my shit. Anyways. So yeah, Valerie's just standing around looking at the guards basically playing cards. Talking amongst each other, drinking ale, you know, usual things at the night. Is Valerie ever going to do anything?
She might play on her flute some. But otherwise, she's relaxing, enjoying her temporary freedom.
Okay. Next up, Leon, you're going to be next.
Yeah, she's been badly tonight.
Yeah, you're not noticed.
You aren't good enough this time. After that amazing performance, we expect that of you all the time. You just don't do it.
So yeah, Leon, you come back. You notice the privates you brought with you are kind of just hanging around as well.
Let them. They can have a couple days off. Fuck it. Shore leave! Or whatever it is for the army.
You gonna do anything interesting before I, you know, go crazy?
Typical tinkering with rifle.
Alright.
Wonder... You can go crazy now.
Okay. Dr. Ephraim Belford, what are you gonna do as you head, as you get back to the caravan and see everyone's kind of relaxing?
Well, I think I'm gonna just wander around and see if anybody needs anything made for them.
Ooh, we might have some fun finally happening.
Yay, Steven's on!
Mm-hmm. There you go. You might actually be able to do something now.
Yes, besides rubbing the bridge of my nose very furiously at the fact that none of you actually freaking talk!
Hey!
I'm trying!
Military!
I've talked to our military guy and a monk who won't talk.
And is no longer in call. So, mild applause, everybody.
We managed to alienate at least one person already.
Well, he decided to go vow of silence.
Yeah, vow of silence, vow of truth, vow of I can't do shit but the party. And is still in the game, but is not in the game. Or a call.
He's an NPC. He's playing an NPC.
Basically.
Practically. Because that's why I don't like vow of silence, especially in a monk. It's just like, you're not part, you don't feel part of the game anymore.
I actually tried to work around that. I handed him a pen and ink. And he said no.
But she denied, mind you.
Yes.
It's just like, vow of silence is not to that extreme. You just can't vocally speak.
I mean, you can take it to that extreme, but you don't have to keep the benefits. Yeah.
Vow of silence specifically has that workaround. You can write things down.
Yeah.
That's mentioned.
Like, he can make sounds if he's, like, doing actions, but outside of that, he can't, like, you know...
speak.
Yeah. Hey, finally someone to keep things interesting.
Yay!
Yo.
I think we're beyond helping.
Oh, please tell me I have someone to actually talk to.
Well, it's interesting about who it is. It's a horse! Congratulations, you've learned the secret.
With sunglasses.
Yes. So,
the most swag horse you will ever see with sunglasses.
I think they're doing that on Netflix now.
So, Steven, how tipsy are you right now?
I shouldn't have drove.
Okay, so...
yes, this will be fun. This is going to be fun.
All right, so, Steven, you're a character.
Describe.
Yeah, I should probably finish that, huh?
Oh, fuck.
Okay, thankfully this is not going to be... thankfully there's not going to be any combat for some time. You're just going to be role-playing.
Alright, give me a second. Dude, I don't even have feats.
Oh, wow.
Oh, this is amazing.
When we got off call at like 5 a.m. the other night, you're like, oh yeah, all I got left are a couple of feats. I fought everything else. I've done everything.
I needed feats and I needed gear.
Oh my god.
And,
I'm so happy.
As of right now, I need feats and gear. Hey, I did skills. That's the difficult shit.
At least you can, you can at least communicate with the party and do things with the party. That's the important thing.
The fun thing about communication, what languages you guys got?
They've got Elven.
Okay, cool. I can talk to you.
Yes.
Except for, the doctor.
What?
The guy is so very... No, he explicitly stated he spoke Elven. Because he spoke Elven to the little girl, remember?
Common, Draconic, Dwarven, Elven.
There we go.
Okay, we're good!
Elven, Undercommon, and Drow Sign Language.
Oh, good. You can talk to the monk.
That's no longer here.
Is there a link for the, thingy?
Oh, didn't I link you? Oh, no, I didn't, because we were both drunk and exhausted that night.
This is amazing. Yeah. This can only get better.
Don't worry, I'll make it worse. Give me a couple.
There you go.
So,
and apologies if I'm not as loud as I should be.
No, you're good.
My mom's literally asleep on the couch like 20 feet away from me.
You're good. We can hear you.
It's good.
It's fine.
All right. Because my mic apparently cuts out if I don't shout at it, but I guess if I... just, you know, talk like this, I'm fine. Whatever.
If you drunkenly talk to it, it works.
For now, anyways.
It respects
the drunken. I verbally stumble through it.
Don't worry. Literally, you didn't miss a whole lot.
You missed him taking revenge on shit that happened to his characters in another game, basically.
No, not even. That wasn't really that what happened. Thanks for playing, though.
First, he throws a character that he nearly got one shot with at us, and then he gets six guards with about permits on another person. Both things his characters got sucked. Yep, screwed with.
No, I was actually doing something, you know. Well, first off, the bound, I did not expect to nearly kill you all. They're fine, crit. And
oh, I'm sorry.
The barbarian.
Let me remind you of a certain boat ramming into one, and the only person that took. Well, no, two people took some very serious wounds from that.
One you pitted a fireproof enemy against the alchemist. Case closed.
It was a random encounter generator. I didn't know what was going to be thrown at us.
You had to hero point yourself to not die.
Yeah, don't remind me. And then there's a hero point thing.
Not in this game, in the other one.
Oh, thank God.
It was amazing. It was his first real session, or no, second session, and he nearly gets one shot. The only thing that saved him was hero points.
That's my favorite.
Okay, and then the permit thing I had happen because, you know, you're in a city that has a fair going on. There's a lot of merchants coming around.
I'll grant you that.
To have permits.
And it just so happens that the whole reason Victor got neutered was because he was a moron and didn't have a magic permit. License, whatever.
I just plopped down and started peddling. I'll grant you that.
Yeah. It wasn't like I was targeting you. You just set yourself up for it.
I did. I'll admit to that. I did. And you know what? I'll do it again. I'm going to start peddling to the caravan members.
You're going to be rather ignored.
You're going to have to roll a good diplomacy score to get my attention. Good luck with that.
All right, I'm just going to pick up two racial feats because those are fun.
Oh, you mean the ones that give you like noble drow shit?
I'm not even going noble drow.
Oh.
As much as I
want
to.
There's my diplomacy roll.
No, I meant like the noble drow feats.
Yeah, I'm looking at them and I don't want them.
Oh. Let me roll to see how many fucks I give. Ready?
I get two
feats
at the
end. It looks like
right?
I'm out of fucks.
So which two did you take? Sorry, no. Also, can I see your character sheet? Because I'm afraid.
I'm not done with it yet.
Damn it.
Alright,
okay.
Two racial.
I'm assuming you're taking Shadowcaster and...
Nope. Nice try.
Oh.
Play again.
Shadowcaster later. I don't get any of the really cool shadow spells yet.
So you're
so why would I get it yet?
Spider Step.
Yep.
And... Don't tell me Spider Summoner as well.
Yes, I am.
Oh, God.
He's good around spiders.
Spiders. Awesome.
Oh, we could have used him earlier.
You
yeah,
literally
where were you?
Spiders without me.
I was shame. Thinking the same thing. They didn't last long. I moved.
No,
well,
but
I didn't even move. I cleaved and killed them.
But still. And you did end up moving at one point.
All right,
well,
now
I
got three grand to spend.
Because somebody got in my way. I couldn't 5 foot step. But... Okay,
Jax.
Everything I'm reading on
so,
this
so you know it's a good night when you walk home and the rum is on the table and fucking Pirates of the Caribbean 3 is on. I literally took that right off the table and sat down. All right, let's play some fucking D&D.
That's amazing.
Okay, so...
I should go get my vodka.
Here's your prompt... Is your prompt to your character being here right now?
Give me a second.
Okay, I'll let you take your swig of rum.
No, I need to put gear on my character real quick.
No.
We don't need the gear immediately.
Yeah, we just imagine her being naked.
Well, it's gonna appear at least like that anyway. That's what the glamored property is for.
Well then!
Drow.
Yeah, fucking
duh. Got to be slutty.
Let's see. I think that roll is still accurate with how many fucks I give.
Right, because you're a taken man.
Damn right. At least for now, we'll see what happens.
Yes.
We'll see what gets thrown at me.
Ah. puns that can be used. Alright,
this is probably going to come up.
Where are the alternate item prices?
Alternate item prices? Question mark?
For alternate materials.
Oh. Hang on.
Equipment. Special materials.
What are you looking for in particular? Oh, God.
Guess.
I have no idea. I don't know. Angel skin?
No. Strike one.
Cold iron?
Nope. Strike two.
Mithril?
Bingo.
It's expensive. Light. You might...
Nope. Closing that page. Not gonna happen.
Yeah, you might be able to get light. Mithril. Which is kind of dumb.
Which is actually rather redundant.
Yeah, at least go medium and do it. Wait a minute, that might actually allow me to be... Ooh. That's actually interesting. I'm going to have to take a look at this further. See if that'll work out for me. that could work. Almost.
Well, anyway, while we've got a bit of time, I'm peddling my wares around the caravan camp.
All right, so that cost double and weighs half.
Get one customer.
He did. That was what that 18 was. That roll was to see
you
how
get
many
fucks
one I
customer.
Gave. And it was not me.
He just browses your wares. Does not buy.
Anything I can make for you.
Browses wares. Does not buy.
Alright, I need a fucking pencil to add this shit up.
I didn't think I'd be bringing out the brandy this soon.
Again.
Welcome to the party, sir.
Again. It's not been a good day for the doctor.
It's
for the cartoon
to
character.
Armor.
Yeah, 150 for masterwork armor.
Like, alright, and the default for skill is...
Why do I still have Nisha's character sheet up? I'm still wondering this right now.
50. I don't know, but I've... something has come to my attention. I feel the need I must message you about.
Oh.
You want to know the best part about this? That all brandy right. is supposed to be for surgical purposes.
I'm afraid for
it
this
came
question.
In the chirurgeon's kit.
Surgeon's kit. That reminds me of a few things. Ain't that right, Nick and Steven?
I don't want to talk about it. I also don't want to talk about the fact that I just wrote down Silkweave Masterwork Scale Mail in my weapon slot. That doesn't go there.
Oh, you're all just frazzled. Swinging around like a flail.
What'd you get?
It's like a towel lip.
Silkweave what? Silver mail?
Arania silk, actually. My bad. I was looking at the both. I went with Arania.
Arania. I'm trying to find that on here.
It's see... under silk Arania.
Silk Arania. I feel like that's not in Pathfinder.
It's a third party.
Are you sure? Because I just looked at it.
It's a 3PP.
Do you need a link? I'll link
third
you.
Third party.
It's oh, under special materials. I see it. I found it.
Silk Arania.
Yes.
It adds a grand and change to the cost and gives DR 3 over slash and blunt.
Okay.
Oh, masterwork is included. Alright, never mind. So I save 150 on that.
Well then. How do you spell it? No.
That's half my cash gone.
want to talk about cash gone.
You spent 2 GP for a permit to sell shit during
after
the fair.
After like 10 hours of waiting in line.
And I had to go back because I didn't actually have money at the time. So I had to go and sell a potion.
The 10 hours included that time. The second time.
Yeah.
But still.
I spent my entire day trying not to get arrested.
Because you're a failure.
Wound up selling one thing.
I figured as much, but it was worth a shot.
Still, 30 gold.
Yeah, no, not in the range we were talking about. Anyways.
No, try a bit more. I was going to have yet more money I had to spend on things. It was getting quite obscene. It was going to get quite obscene, really.
Yes, and I was going to have to dropkick him from the party. Anyway, Stephen, are you all set?
I'm half broke, sir.
Are you at least set to roleplay things out?
I could, but until I know what gear I have available, I'm not entirely comfortable with it.
Okay, we'll wait till you're comfortable, because at this point, the party's just right now.
Nick, can you throw it on your character sheet? I just want to copy-paste your gorget. Ed, Eric, whatever your name is. Hey, Alahara.
There you go.
Whatever the fuck his name is.
Yay.
Oh, there's Slayer archetypes. I did not know that.
The class, isn't it?
Wow, so you could have two layers of armor with the... with that. Kind of.
It's nice, but... I mean, DR3...
Slashing
and bludgeoning.
That's actually pretty good, because that makes you immune to most damage. Surprisingly.
It's DR3 over slash and blunt, so it has to be a blunt slashy weapon, right?
Yeah.
Somehow.
Yes. Which,
PAC has done it.
I think the Morningstar, maybe?
That might be the only one that does, and that might even be Bludgeon Pierce. I think it is. I don't think anything get through it, really.
I think bites get through, because bites are all three.
This is true.
Bites are all
I think
so,
I mean, monks can get through it once they hit a certain point, because then they're just like, I don't care, my fists do everything. I am somehow cutting you with my fist, and also piercing through your body. Why? Because...
Don't mess with the monk.
Claws are either piercing or slashing, or bludgeoning and slashing. Claws. Don't remember off the top of my head.
Claws are straight slash.
They're split.
Are they?
They're split.
Cool.
I do B&P with mine, so I can't hurt you. Well, I could.
Oh,
if I rolled, like, not like ass.
They operate, you said they operate as, as the rings, right?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, I didn't specifically write that down. I was just using that as my neck guard.
Well, you both have collars like that.
But I don't think I ever specifically wrote that on my character sheet. Mm. Not that it matters a whole lot. It's more fluff than it is functionality.
A lot of things in this world we do is more fluff than functionality.
Fluff is fun.
Amen to that.
Truth.
If you have not seen the backstory I made for my last character, you would... Like, that backstory. Huh, Nick?
You said we could take a drawback, right?
Yes, you could. Oh, God, I'm afraid.
Is there any point to taking a drawback besides just doing a drawback to add flavor?
If you take a drawback, you can get a third trait.
Oh. A third trait? Oh, right. I need two more traits, don't I?
Oh, well, in that case.
Yeah, one of them is a campaign, which you probably already know which one you're taking.
I already have that one. I have the loathing one.
Goes up
yep.
there.
Then you only get two more.
Up there. I just want to make sure, but...
Hope we're not boring you over there, Jeff.
Before I... Yeah.
I'm good.
It's, before I do
just
this,
opened
should...
another window and I'm browsing now.
Before I do this...
Let me know when we get back to things.
Yeah. Because this is best. This is probably going to be the best way to introduce Steven's character.
This has been the best live stream ever.
I can use elf traits, right?
Are you still streaming, by the way?
Da.
I'm assuming someone that you know is watching it.
Probably. Maybe. I don't know.
Can I use elf traits?
No.
I can't use elf traits on my drow elf?
No.
No. Because they're... Wait.
I don't...
I mean, obviously I'm not going to go for any of the ridiculous ones. I'm just wondering if I can even look at them.
Let me take, like... Are there, like, specific drow traits?
I can't find any.
Then I have to say yes. Yes.
Drow were created when some elves left the world and some elves buried themselves.
And others waited for the world to crumble.
Well, that's when I said buried themselves. They went underground to hide while the cataclysmic event that happened. And then the rest of the elves came back, and then the drow came up out of the ground.
All right.
Yeah,
then go for it.
There's two of them I like. There's Forlorn, which is an elf trait. Described as having lived outside the traditional elf society for much or all of your life, you know the world can be cruel, dangerous, and unforgiving to the weak. It's a +1 fort saves.
Go for it.
Cool.
Because that's totally not a drow.
Yeah, I know.
That's exactly
right?
What a drow is.
I could care less at this point.
Yay, trait bonus to saves. And they need to pick up a drawback because I want Warrior of Old. As a child, you put in long hours on combat drills. And
can't you only take one racial trait, though?
In memory, you still have a knack for quickly responding to trouble.
Yeah, you can.
So
you took a drawback.
Yeah, but
I'm taking
that
a drawback.
I don't think
you can still only take one
trait from
each
thing category.
Though. Ah. In which case, screw Forlorn, I want Warrior of Old.
What you can do is you can take Forlorn, and then you, for combat trait, you take Reactionary, which is the same thing.
How about I just take both?
Okay. I have no way to say no to that. DM?
Trait bonuses are one of the few bonuses that do stack.
They do stack.
Rules. Core rule wise.
Yeah.
Exactly. So as long as it's not from the same category, that's the only rule on trades. You can only take one from each category.
Mm-hmm.
At least core wise.
Hey, there's a drawback, Mark of Slavery.
I know, right? It's almost like it fits your character or something.
I didn't see that.
Oh, so we're gonna have two slaves in the party now.
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, no one knows anything about me, huh?
Yeah, basically they've seen you, but they haven't really walked up to you and say, hey, how's it going?
I know.
And nobody's talked to the slave that's actually been active, so I haven't said anything.
I know anyway.
Well, for a good chunk of that time, you were unconscious, so...
Yes.
Hey, there's been in-game, like, 4 days, okay?
You were unconscious for at least one of those.
No, it was like 2 hours, if that. Well, no, I was sleeping. So, like 10 hours. Like half a day. It doesn't count.
I'm just going to come out and say it. You are not good people to talk to.
Shadow Scarred, whenever you're in an area of dim light or darkness, you take a -1 in saving throws. You know, we're drow excel. Nope, not taking that. Alright, so I'm debating between provincial and xenophobic. -2 on diplomacy checks and scent motives checks made against all creatures whose religion or alignment differs from your own, so everyone. or minus two in diplomacy and sense motive checks made against creatures of a different race or from a different culture.
Which is everyone.
I'm just looking at the flavor form because they're the same penalty because it's both everyone. So is it you have a hard time understanding and trusting those with unfamiliar ways and appearances, or you have only one way of looking at things the right way? I like that. That
depends. Are you Malto or are you a different character?
Honey, everyone I play is Malto.
It's secretly Malto. Always.
Time for me to make sure that these two traits are not in the same category. I don't think they are, but...
What I just said?
No. For me.
Oh.
Something else in the background. Someone didn't understand how traits work.
No, it's because we had discussed something earlier, and you've obviously forgotten, and it's in my benefit, so I'm going to run with it.
Okay.
That was easy enough.
And one of the combat traits was reactionary, you guys said?
Yes.
Yes.
Plus two to initiative.
I think reactionary is a... No, wait, there's a... Never mind. Ignore me.
Damn it!
I am going to murder you.
I kind of like that, but I kind of don't. I'm going to go with Armor Expert.